Thanks for joining us. Today we are going to create a two-flight staircase with railings and gratings as the floor on the platform in SOLIDWORKS using SolidSteel Parametric. The process is quicker than you might think, so we'll jump into it with this sketch as our starting point. The correct tool is of course stairs, and we select this start line and this end line for placement. We immediately get a preview, and in this case the settings of the stairs are already correct with the horizontal extension at the top and the vertical extension at the bottom because SolidSteel always remembers the last setting used. All we need to do now is to click on the configure button in the settings and check the offset of the floor and the steps one tap. The 50 mm entered is correct and corresponds to the height of the grating that will be used later on the landing. We can close the menu and confirm all the entries by clicking on the green check mark to place the stair. I'm going to let it run in real time for now. In the rest of the video, I will always show real time the first time I use a feature, and then speed up the video the next time I use the same feature to save some time. Okay, the first stair is in place. Let's move on to the second. We start the stair feature, place the stair from this start line to this end line and get the preview. As you can see, SolidSteel has memorized the last entries this time too, but they do not fit here. We have to change parameters. The stringers and steps, which can be selected here in the menu on the left, will of course remain the same as they were for the first staircase. The other geometric attributes are set in the configure menu. The position is already correct. We can go directly to the extensions. At the top 600 mm is enough, and at the bottom we don't need a vertical extension but a horizontal one, and here 800 mm is suitable. For the steps we don't need an additional step, but we have to take into account the floor offset for the gratings. No, not 500 mm, but 50 mm. You can clearly see in the background how the steps move with the offset to adjust the rise. With the incorrectly entered 500 mm, the number of steps has of course also been reduced to just 4. We can also keep the 50 mm floor offset at the top if we want to use a grating there as well. We can close the menu with the entries and confirm again with the green checkmark to insert the staircase, now in fast forward. Well, both stairs are now placed, but we still need a few more profiles to complete the construction. We start the beams on lines feature and select the appropriate sketch line where we want to place a U-profile. In the preview, we can now see that it is not a U-profile and quickly correct it to a U-profile with a height of 200 mm. This is the wrong way around. The flip start end option corrects this. Since the default placement is always centered, we now use a parallel offset so that the new beam is flush with the existing beams of the stair landings at the top. We want to place more beams, so I pin the menu to keep it open after confirming. The U profile is in place and we continue with the columns. So we select a sketch line again, get the preview, set the appropriate I profile for the column. For example, an IP180, set the parallel offset to bottom to move the beam inwards. I admit that the offset sounds confusing at first, so here is a brief explanation. The offsets always refer to the cross-section of the profile in the standard orientation. This cross-section contains the 9 possible points at which the profile can be placed on the line. After a short period of practice, you will get it right intuitively. Okay, you can get very far with just these standard alignments, but it's not always enough. It's the same here, because I want to move the column even further so that we have enough room for the end plate later. To do this, first use the start offset with 80 mm. With this, you have now learned how to place profiles at an angle on orthogonal sketch lines. However, I want to stay orthogonal here, so I also add an end offset of 80 mm and confirm. On the other side, we insert another column in exactly the same way. The only difference here is that the parallel offset is now set to top and there is a minus in front of the 80 mm for the other offsets because this time we are pushing the column in the opposite direction. Confirm, and with this we have now placed all the profiles we need here. Looks pretty good, but the profiles are obviously intersecting. One way to fix this is to use the cut functions, and we'll take a look at that here with the face cut tool. We first select the face on which we want to cut, and then all the profiles that are to be cut. Here we can also define a gap. I choose 10 mm. Confirm, and all 4 profiles are shortened in a single step. The columns still penetrate the rest. We could shorten them with a cut, but we will simply use the end plate feature which already contains the cut that matches the end plate. To place the end plate, we first select the beam and then the face we want to connect to. We could select a standard end plate from the presets, but since it will be a custom end plate at this point, we will simply define it ourselves. Well, we don't need a double plate here. We make the plate a little wider on the left and right, and also longer in both directions, so we have enough room for the screws later, and we just leave the plate thickness at 25 millimeters. The whole pattern can be defined below the dimensions. Here we do not want symmetrical columns of holes and reduce the number to one column. By changing to one, the holes are automatically centered on the axis of the columns. We can also use this for the rows. As we want to have two holes, we can simply confirm the existing two again with enter, and the holes will center themselves here too. Here we can define the distance from the edge, for example 45 millimeters, and here we define the distance between the holes, so we enter the value that is the plate width minus twice the edge distance to get a symmetrical end plate. Here it is 250 millimeters. Looks good. We can now define the bolted connection by clicking on Assemble here to open the part selection. We select the appropriate standard and a suitable diameter. Clicking on Default Mountings adds two matching washers and a nut, and we can confirm. We'll flip the bolts. It's easier to mount on site if the bolt doesn't slip out of the hole. Okay, we pin the dialogue and confirm. The first end plate connection has been made and the column has also been cut automatically. On the second side, the process is faster because SolidSteel Parametric has remembered the parameters of the last end plate. So all we have to do is select the column and the face, and we can confirm directly. The connections from the stairs to the horizontal beam are still missing. This could also have been done with end plates, but I use the clip angle connections. With the tool activated, simply select both connection faces, the preview fits, pin the dialogue and confirm. This is now done three more times and fast forward, the steps are always the same. Alright, now that everything is firmly connected, the railings and the gratings are still missing. We start with the railings and there is also a suitable tool for this in SolidSteel Parametric. The railing will be attached to the side, so we select side for position and the right template is type A side, which is included with SolidSteel. We select a face and an edge to place the railing and get a schematic preview showing us the start, end and height of the railing. We define a few more offsets, for example minus 50 millimeters at the start, and also minus 50 millimeters at the end. Pin the dialog again so that it remains open for the following railings and confirm. Here is the first railing in real time. By the way, the railings are template based. An independent copy of the template is created and then customized. For now, I'm going to add all the railings without any further modifications, then adjust them later and connect them at the corners. Here is the short railing section with the start offset set to 0 mm so that the railing posts are exactly on top of each other, and the end offset set to 125 mm so that the overhang fits to the projection of the next railing. We'll see why I do it this way in a moment with the corner joints. The remaining railings now continue in fast forward, the steps are always the same, only the start and end offsets are always adjusted so that the railings fit together well. On the short railing, you can also see that it is the same template with the four panels that are now much too narrow. But as I said, don't worry, we'll fix that in a moment. It's not a problem because the railing is parametric. You can also create your own railing templates, or copy the supplied templates, and adapt them to your requirements. If you are interested in stairs and railings and would like to see the entire process in real time, I recommend the webinar video linked in the description. Okay, now that we have all the railings added, let's take care of the details. We start the custom railings dialog again. Switch to the equations tab and select the short railing section. Here in the equations we can now see the parameters that we can set. We can set the number of segments to 1 and the number of bars in the segment to 8. Since the segment here is a little wider than the sloped railings. Confirm and the update will be executed. Looks good, we'll do it again directly on the opposite side, 1 segment, 8 bars, confirm. I'll leave the rest of the railings as they are to keep the video short. Of course, if the staircase is really going to be built like this, I would adjust the parameters of the other railings so that there is no overlap between the fastening of the posts and the screws of the steps. For example, by reducing the number of segments there to 3. At this point, we have just placed the offsets so that the posts are on top of each other. Here we need to select one post and suppress all the parts. Otherwise, we will get the wrong quantities in subsequent processes such as the bill of materials. Here, for example, we would have to suppress this post including the small part here above, and also here below the short flat bar and the mounting plate. Here at the top of the handrail we make a miter cut with the cut beams tool and the miter cut option. Simply select both parts and confirm. The appropriate cutting angle is calculated automatically. Here at the corner, we have two posts that are rotated 90 degrees, and we can suppress both of them. The small part here as well. Then we can also insert miter cuts here, once at the handrail, as we just did, but also here with the small round material to connect the segments at the corner. Now we repeat exactly the steps just shown on the opposite side, again in fast forward. The railing is now finished. All that remains is the missing floor of the landing. We now fix this with gratings, and to lay them out, we repurpose the solid steel facade feature, which is well suited for this task. The sketch for the installation is already prepared. Now we can select the type of facade we want to use in the task pane on the right. In this case, we switch to the gratings category and can see the list of different sizes available. There is also a small sketch where you can see what the dimensions mean and more info by hovering over it. It is important to mention that gratings are not a standard category of the facade module. Both the category and the sizes were created by me, but you can do it too. We will also make a short video about it. Okay, let's move on. I already selected a grating with a width of 50 centimeters and a height of 50 millimeters. When selecting the sketch lines, I select the length direction first, then another line for the width direction. Now we simply select all the lines that represent the outline of our floor one by one. We can now confirm and wait for the result. This takes a little while, during which the facade module automatically inserts the gratings into the area defined by the lines and also creates the thicker edging around the gratings. We'll see in a moment. Yes, now it's done. Here we can see the five individual gratings and the appropriate lengths required for the platform. The staircase is now complete, and if you would like to see how to automatically create a bill of materials, workshop drawings, sheet metal export to DXF, and even NC data of the staircase and railing, just click on the video suggested here. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video.